And welcome to day 27 of our fall daily draw. My name is Miss Ashley, and today we are going to be drawing a skunk. So let's go ahead and get started with our blank piece of paper. I want you to use a pencil, but I'll be using a sharpie so you can see my lines. Now make sure your paper is vertical, which means up and down. And the first thing we're going to do is draw that square in the top right corner. Now, since today is November 27th, I'm going to go ahead and draw that number 27. And you can write your numbers however you would like. And once you are done with that, we're going to go ahead and get started with our skunk. Now the first thing you need to do, you're going to go roughly in the middle of your paper and draw a curved line. Now this is going to be the bottom of our skunk's head. Right here is the nose. So we're actually going to curve down and up. But we're actually going to extend that curve all the way down. And right here will be the ear and a small rainbow curve for the inside of the ear. We're going to leave this area alone for right now. We are going to start drawing the skunk's back. You're going to go right here and curve and down. We'll curve out and draw those toes. And then you're gonna bring this curve up, but make sure not to go all the way because we want to show that this is part of the leg and this is the back. And then you're gonna just draw a slight rainbow curve. Make sure you do not connect here because then you're gonna draw two lines going down and then a few backward C's for the paw. Now we do need to add the other legs. So in this space here, we're going to curve those down and then backward C's. And I'm just adding two of those backward C's. This is where our skunk's chest is. That goes to the neck. So we're gonna bring this curve down and another curve and then a U-shaped curve and another U-shaped curve and make sure it connects. Now with our skunk's nose, I'm just going to add a small curve. You can even draw a small circle if you wanted to. And the eye, I'm gonna draw a rainbow with an oval on the left with a small backward C. And then you can give your skunk a smile. Now right now it kind of looks like a baby bear, so we do need to add that tail. And you're gonna start on the back of our skunk and curve up and down. And then you're gonna go up, down, up, down, up, and bring that curve back to the skunk. Now let's go ahead and add those areas where it's going to be white. I'm just adding those simple zigzags on the top of the head, zigzags on the back, and then zigzags up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, and down. So we're just going to repeat that step on the other side too. Down, up, down, up. You're going to keep doing that until you get back to the skunk. Now make sure before you do start coloring, you do erase this line here where the ear is. So make sure where I'm coloring it in brown, U-E race. Now your skunk is looking up at the sky, so maybe you want to draw a falling leaf or maybe a butterfly. That's up to you. I'm just going to draw a simple butterfly though. But you can have a leaf falling or a different bug. That's up to you. You can also add some simple designs like leaves on the ground. Just a few things here and there. So go ahead and take that moment to add any of those simple items around your picture. But when you are done, your picture should look something like this. So this is mine in pencil with my butterfly and a few leaves. So when you are done with your picture, you can go ahead and start to outline everything with your Sharpie. I'm just carefully outlining. And I'm also going to fill in those larger areas of my numbers. And I'll do that with Sharpie. On the 7. And then we'll go ahead and outline our skunk. And you can notice that I made sure to erase that line that was going through the ear. And I'm also going to fill in my nose and the part of the eye that's looking up at my butterfly. And take your time with outlining those lines. There's no rush. Stripe on the back and the tail. And also my butterfly. I'm just going to fill in that body too, and I want this to be an orange and black butterfly, so I'm just going to add some of those line details with my Sharpie. And also, I'm not going to forget my leaves either. When you are done with your outlining your picture, you're going to go ahead and grab that eraser and erase any pencil lines that you may see. Outlining my skunk, I'm going to go ahead and take out my watercolors, and I'll also put my pencil away. Now I want to make sure that my black watercolor is not too dark. The more water you add to your watercolors, the lighter it will be. So I want to make sure that I'm only using just a little bit of black for my skunk. I'm making sure to spread that evenly around. I'm avoiding the areas where the white stripe is. And if you need a smaller brush to get to those areas where the toes are, you can go ahead and do so. Again, if you have too much black paint, just make sure to add more water and really try your best to spread that paint around. And I'm trying my best to avoid that eye. Really spread it around. And also those legs behind. I'm going to switch my smaller brush just because some of those areas are a little bit hard to get to. I'm going to make sure to spread that paint around. And you definitely don't want that black paint to be too dark, just because it would be a little bit harder to see that skunk. Add a little bit more just to make sure that that color is evenly distributed. Body painted. I'm going to move to the tail. Really trying my best to spread that paint. And once again, if you do need to switch to that smaller brush, that is okay. Now, you don't have to use watercolors for your picture. You can use colored pencils or chalk pastels. That's up to you. I just like using the watercolors because it spreads really nicely, and I like the color of black that shows up. You can always go back to some of those areas just to make sure it's a bit darker. Maybe add a little bit of shading here and there. Just make sure it's still not too dark if you do add that shading. All right, now that my skunk is completely colored, I'm going to add some orange to that butterfly. And then I am going to add some paint to the ground. I'm going to do a variation of reds and browns and oranges. And all I'm doing is I'm just going back and forth with my brush. Be careful though, make sure you don't paint over your skunk because that black paint can spread on your paper. I'm just spreading it back and forth, trying my best to avoid painting on my skunk. I do want it to be pretty close to the legs. All So you can leave some of those areas white if you would like. I'm just gonna get some browns and go back and forth, just so it looks a little bit more like dirt or sand possibly. Also go underneath with brown and add a shadow underneath your skunk. And also you can go in and add some of those reds for the leaves. Dry, if you'd like to, you can take that a bit further with colored pencil. Maybe you want to add some extra shading to that skunk or maybe some smaller plants, but that is totally up to you. And this is our picture and the end of this video. Thank you so much for joining me for today's daily draw, and we will see you tomorrow. Bye!